What up, homies and homettes? It's your boy, Bradah Smokey. Man, getting out today. Shit, it was snowing like the past week, bruh. So I couldn't get out. But today, man, it's even like a little bit, like some spots got snow on the ground, but it's not too bad. So, man, gonna get it in because I gotta go back to work in a couple days. So, trying to get it in, man. But, yeah, man, glad to be back. Glad to be bringing you another video, man. Oh, and I appreciate everybody who be stay subscribed. Much love. Today, I gotta go cash my check. I get a paper check. I don't really care for direct deposit. I don't even have a fucking bank card, debit card. I like cash. I like carrying cash. Feel like it's a little bit better. So that's why I do that, man. You know, like when you get a card, you just end up like swiping that shit and swiping that shit, and you lose track. When you get cash, you look in your wallet and it's like, damn, I only got this much left, so I better take it easy, man. But yeah, I'm gonna cash my check. Got some shit, some bills I gotta pay for. Other than that, man, just trying to enjoy this day, just getting this riding. I don't know if you guys keep up with football, but the owner of the New England Patriots, man, that motherfucker got caught for prostitution, man. Now, I don't know what you guys' thoughts is on prostitution, but I feel like that shit should be legal, man. It shouldn't be such a big deal. But for some reason, that shit is a big deal, man. So I don't fucking know. But whatever. I mean, I guess I do kind of understand why that shit's illegal, but at the same time, man, if there's a girl or a female or shit, even a male who agrees to the sex and, you know, in return get compensated by money, man, what the fuck's the problem with that, bro? I'm not saying that I would do it, but I'm just saying, like, what is the problem with that? Bitch wants to fuck, he wants to fuck, she wants some money, he's willing to give some money. What, like, everybody's in agreement. What is wrong with that? I don't know, man. Apparently it's a big deal, man. I don't get it, but apparently it's a big deal. So he be facing two charges. Fucking, I guess like it's a investigation that been going on for like 6-7 months. So he got caught, got like video evidence. He's of course denying it, as 99% of people do. But he got caught. Sheriff deputy says that on two different accounts, he was on video receiving the sexual acts for money. I mean, think about it, man. That's crazy just to have to watch that shit. You know what I mean? Because you have to know for sure that it happened and went down. So being the people watching that shit is just weird. It's crazy. But yeah, man, you know, that just shows that you don't really know somebody, man. Like, you think you know somebody, but you really don't. This kind of thing, man, he the last person that I would have thought would have did that. And, you know, that's kind of what they say, though. It's the ones that you least expect. Just like suicide. It's always the people that you would never expect to do it, doing it. For whatever reason. That's just kind of, I don't know, man. It's just what it is. Because, to be honest, when I first heard about it, I was like, nah, man, that's just some bullshit, you know, just some rumors. Bitches just trying to get money or whatnot. Nah, man, like, sheriff and cops and police and whatever the fuck you call them, deputies, talking about they got video evidence, man. So, you know, video don't lie, of course. So, you know, if you get caught on camera, on video, you know, you get caught, man. You can deny it all you want, but, you know, it just shows that, you know, you don't really have too much credibility, you know, like, you know, you're still lying about it. Yet, you know, there's visual proof. I mean, you know, it's embarrassing. It's it's a tough pill to swallow if you're a New England Patriots fan. Yeah, man, you just don't really want to be hearing about shit like that. But it is what it is, man. It is what it is. It's some new places leasing, man. I remember when I moved up here, that shit was like, this shit didn't exist. Now they got that shit up leasing. I actually seen an ad for I saw the layout and that shit's pretty nice, man. Like, you definitely gotta have some money to be there. I mean not much, but for the amount that rent goes in Colorado Springs, yeah, that's, you know, on a little bit pricier side, but you know, still affordable. You know, as you guys already know, I go to the gym a lot. Shit, I go to the gym literally every day. And you know how it is every year. People's New Year's resolutions is to, you know, get fit, you know, live a healthier lifestyle. You know, I don't know if, you know, some of them got kids or grandkids that they want to be around for, you know, so they try to, you know, be healthy. And, you know, like usually, like 70-75% of the people who have that New Year's resolution don't make it past the first month. And the gym that I'd be going to, you know, had a lot of people, you know, the beginning of the year, you know, the first week of January, that I'd be going to the gym. And, you know, here I'm thinking that, oh, you know, it's just going to be a, you know, like a temporary thing. And then, you know, it's going to fizzle out like it does every year. But no, man, that should be fucking popping. Like, I usually go at like 10 in the morning. Sometimes I'll go again at night with my girl. But, yeah, man, that shit is happening, bro. Like, it's still fucking crowded. People just be getting it in, man. Like, they're taking that shit serious this year. I'd say, like, out of all the new people that are members at the gym that I go to, I'd say maybe 80%, 8 out of 10 people still be attending the gym. So it's, you know, kudos to them, man. You know, good shit. You know, get that money, stay on that grind, because, you know, my girl was saying it only take like, shit, I want to say she said like a month or some shit for you to like develop a habit if you constantly do it. So, you know, they're past that shit already. So hopefully it's one of those things that they can continue to stick with, because, you know, it's a, I'm not saying that it's bad if you don't go to the gym, but, you know, it's definitely a good thing. Definitely a good thing. There's definitely a lot of other vices that people have that are, you know, detrimental to them. So glad to see everybody there, man. Glad to see it. Wally World. Shit, I'm always at Wally World, man. This is where I go grocery shopping. I don't go to grocery stores. I go to, well, I mean, I guess Walmart kinda is one, but I don't go to like sole grocery stores. Like Safeway and shit like that. I go to this motherfucker, man. Walmart. Sometimes it should be on sale. Sometimes it should be a little cheaper, man. You gotta be in the business of saving that money, man. I don't know if you guys remember my last video, but remember when I went to the Batteries Plus? That was the one that I went to prior to the one that I actually got my GoPro battery. And it turns out they ended up having it there. They just... fuck, I guess their employees wasn't too knowledgeable on the product that I wanted, so yep, better study up, boys. Let me head up in this Walmart, cash my check, let me get something to eat and be back on this bitch, bro.
Moments later.
So we'd be leaving the gas station, man. Came out of Walmart, fool was telling me about couldn't park my bike there on the side. She has like a fire lane and it goes from the door. All I see is fucking zebra red lines on the ground, so whatever, bro. He was just hating. That's all it is. But yeah, I had to put in some gas. I had to get that gasolina. Should be smelling good as fuck, man. Now gonna go hit up a Safeway. My girl gotta go. Well, not gotta, but my girl wanna grab some scratch tickets, so we gonna do that, man. We gonna do that. Shit, I forget what I was talking about before I went to Walmart. Back to the Robert Kraft situation. Man, to each their own on that, bro. To each their own, man. I mean, I don't condone prostitution, but I don't, like, I wouldn't mind if that shit was legal, you know what I'm saying? Like, it just doesn't make sense to me. Now, I can understand if you know, it was like human trafficking. Okay, now that's a different story, because that's like against their will and shit. But, you know, if a bitch wants to get down and give you some head or, you know, or fuck, you know what I'm saying? Like, and in return to give them some money and you yourself don't mind? Bro, I don't see what the problem is. see, the ones who are against it are the ones who do it. Like, there are some who are against it so hard that I bet you, man, they're the very ones who be doing that shady ass shit, man. But hey, like almost everything in this world, man, to each their own, man. To each their own. So summer is approaching, man. Actually, not summer. It's a spring approaching, if it's not already here already. And the weather's, you know, getting better. Be talking about, I've been reading some forums and on Facebook and shit. I mean, I'm part of like this motorcycle group in the Springs, Colorado Springs, and they be talking about getting like group rides together and get this shit going. But man, if you remember my other videos, I don't really do the whole group ride shit, man. I've been asked like a whole bunch, to be honest. I mean, not bragging or anything, but I've been asked like a whole bunch, and I honestly feel like they would catch the clue and be like, damn, this fool never said once yet. I tell them, hey, you know, maybe you'll see me on the road, whatnot, but as far as like an organized ride, not my thing, man. Not my thing. I'm more of a solo renegade, man. Solo renegade. I just ride by myself or with my girl. But literally, that's it. I don't know, man. I like it like that. You know, I like riding by myself, you know? Not everybody that rides has a good riding etiquette. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got, like, some idiots and shit who don't really know what the fuck they're doing and shit. So it's, you know, it's kind of tough, man. It's kind of tough. You know, fools want to do wheelies and fools want to do tricks, and you know, I'm all for that, bro. You know, I mean, you do you, but man, you like, you gotta give a fool some space, man. You know, not everybody wants to be close as fuck, you know. I don't know, maybe that's just me, but the group rides, man, you probably never see me in a group ride. Now, you know, if any of you guys are in the area, in Colorado or whatever, you know, you guys want to get in a ride or get something to eat, man, I'll be all down for it. But don't be inviting like your posse, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm gonna roll up to it and I'm gonna roll right back out. But you know, nothing against group rides, you know, I don't want to sound like a hater, it's just, you know, it's not my cup of tea, that's all it is. But I understand, you know, the desire to want to ride in a group. You know, you're with like-minded individuals. You know, everybody got a bike, you know, that bike life, you know. I get it. Just, not my scene, man. Not my scene. I don't have no stop sign. Yeah, to turn, you stupid fucking idiot. Bro, fuck you. Fuck that guy, man. That actually, in my other video, actually in my girl's video, I think like her last one or the one before last, this motherfucker almost whacked me. He came in my lane. Like he overpassed me or passed me while in my fucking lane, bro. Now imagine that, a car taking you over while you're in the lane and they are like basically in that lane as well. Bro, rolled up to that fool, knocked on his window. I was like, bro, you're lucky, bro. You're lucky. He was an old man. I mean, not too old, but you know, he's like 50, look like. I was actually kind of hoping he was like 20 or 30 or some shit. You know, I was fucking pissed, bro. I was fucking pissed, but, you know, what are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Alright, I'm gonna go grab the scratch tickets and then probably head on our way home and then I'm gonna call it a day, man.
More moments later.
Alright, so we're just leaving Safeway. Got my scratch tickets. Man, I don't wanna say I'm addicted to it, but, you know, who doesn't wanna win the lottery, man? You know what I'm saying? Shit, if you don't want to win the lottery, man, something wrong with you, bro. And the only way to win the lottery, bro, is to play. It's the only way. You gotta play. Unless you play, you ain't gonna win, man. So we got that done. Probably gonna get something to eat. Probably get in a couple hits with my girl. And then head back to the house. I gotta go grab my car and get some groceries, man. Gotta fill up that icebox, man. But I'm gonna wrap my video right here. You know, just a regular video. Nothing crazy. Just some recent topics, if you guys heard about it. If you guys haven't, you know, some of the shit I talked about, just look it up, man. Get a little bit more information, a little bit more detailed information. I'll probably try and get more footage tomorrow before I go to work. Get another video in there, maybe two. Because, yeah, I'm going to be out of town for work. But I'll post while I'm out of town so I can keep it up. Yeah, man. Probably going to... I gotta go hit up the dispensary tomorrow. Gotta grab some weed. I'd be almost dry. So I got enough for today, and I gotta grab some tomorrow. So I told my girl, let's go ride out to it. It's about a 40-minute ride, I think, or a 40-minute drive. So maybe like half an hour, 25-minute ride. So hoping that she's down to do that, because you know, I mean, I will ride by myself if I have to, but you know, I don't want to. Plus, you know, if she knows that I'm gonna ride, she'll ride. So as long as, you know, the weather's right and shit like that, then, you know, we'll be all right. But thanks for watching my video, man. You know, I appreciate it as always. You know, much love. Take the time out of the day to watch my video. You know, 15, 16 minutes video. You know, it's 15, 16 minutes that you could have been doing something else. So the fact you chose to watch my video, hey, man, much love. Definitely appreciate it, man. Until next time, man, stay safe, ride safe, stay up on them two wheels, you know. If the weather is bad, you know, pray for better weather. And when the weather is good, man, get out there and ride, man. Other than that, man, get that money, bruh.